You don't know Arabic. Don't believe what I say, okay? But you already told me 97% of the world follows the Hafs Quran. That is the Hafs Quran. That's the Khalid Quran, okay? This Quran is different from Hafs Quran in 5,000 places. When you make a deep dive, okay? There are 5,000 textual variations between them. But you don't know Arabic, don't believe in me. Let's go to your Muslim missionaries. Actually, it was Gabriel, not me. I couldn't do anything. Gabriel takes the full responsibility. Those were the words of Satan.
So he was the one.
What was the reference?
The reference you told me, right? To Tabari, volume 6, chapter.
No. Tabari goes. Yeah, that's the page number.
Oh, yeah, page 107.
So according to the hadith that Muhammad is bowing down, worshipping the pagans. Yeah. And then you can also get the similar in Ibn Ishaq, page 165, 166. Ibn Ishaq.
Ibn Ishaq.
Page 165, 166. Then God sent down by the stars when it said, you're condemned, earth are not, and is not deceived. He speaks not from his own desire. When he reached his words, have you thought of Al-Alat, Al-Uzra, and Manat, the third, the other? Satan, when he was meditating upon it and desiring to bring it to the people, put upon his tongue those verses, and then Surah 53 is quotation. Why are you running away, sir? Then Gabriel came to the Muhammad and then said, what have you done, Muhammad? You have read the verses, something I did not bring you from God. You have said something that God did not say.
So now you know.
Ibn Ishaq.
Now you know why I'm
165,
not hold him from the right hand.
Ibn what?
Ibn Ishaq.
Ibn Ishaq.
Ishaq. Yeah, 165, 166.
Okay.
That's the earliest biography of Muhammad.
Yeah, I've heard about him.
It's not you heard about it. As a Muslim, yeah. You should know about it. It's the biography of Muhammad.
He was a betrayer.
No.
Ibn Ishaq. But I'm not going to believe it.
Yeah, you don't know. You learn.
So just tell me the page. Tell me the page.
Page 165, 166.
Okay. Ibn Ishaq, volume.
Ibn Ishaq is a book. Right. Just a bio of Muhammad. Go to page 165, 166.
165, 166.
Right. Sorry, brother. It wasn't my intention to hijack.
It's good.
He's just like getting around with the simple.
So far,
I would expect from now on to not make any claim or any statement that Muhammad comes from the lineage of Abraham.
No.
And then don't ever say to brother or anyone else that Muhammad was monotheist, Muhammad was pagan worshipper, and he worshipped the pagans. Yes. In his prophethood.
Until I bring information that contradicts.
And the clear proof is this, that Muhammad was seized by Allah from the right hand because of a bringing of false revelation. So that what Quran says, that if somebody is going to bring a false revelation, Allah is going to seize him from the right hand. So this is what Muhammad was seized
if you make
with
lies,
the right hand.
If you make lies about us, we will cut your head off.
Huh?
Yeah. If you make lies about us, I will cut your head
off.
And then his aorta is gone.
Yeah.
I still feel the pain which was caused to me in Kabar as I ate that food. I feel my aorta is being cut off.
Do you remember the debate you had with Zakir Hussain?
Who is Zakir Hussain?
What? Zakir Hussain, the one I had debate with when you said that.
I don't care. Anyway, just answer.
No, Zakir Hussain.
I don't care about that. Just answer our question. So.
Right, because it wasn't the right Arabic translation of iota and whatever that hadith.
Bring
was.
The reference.
Yeah, so it was Wasim, I think.
Sir,
Wasim.
Sir.
The Arabic word was Wasim.
Sir.
Right.
I've got the dictionary. I can pull it up for you now. The word in the hadith. as the word in the Quran is being used, the same word, his aorta is being cut off. I am sorry, Allah failed in Arabic.
Yeah.
I can't do much about it, but yes, Allah made that.
And also, sister, the translation is done by Muslim.
Who was actually a medical doctor?
And the Quran is
he's a medical doctor.
By Allah. So who is responsible? Allah and the translator, not us.
Both of them messed up.
Yes.
If you disagree, just bring your evidence, sir.
Yeah, of course.
But brother, thank you for reminding this young gentleman that Allah killed Muhammad for the lies
that's
he
right.
made it up.
Yeah, this is what I told.
That's right.
Huh? Bring your evidence.
No. I'm speaking true. I'm not a lie. I have seen a debate with you and someone.
Bring your evidence.
On this topic, but yeah.
Bring your evidence.
On what topic?
Well, the topic was it Jibril? Did Jibril said that I am Jibril? And he said, did Gabriel say I am Gabriel?
No.
When did Gabriel say that I am
no.
Gabriel?
No. When he appeared to Muhammad, he never introduced.
Right. He never.
He
said
never
that
introduced
I
that I am a Gabriel.
Right.
He
right.
never introduced.
That's the, well, that was the argument.
But so brother, before that,
yes.
When he came, Gabriel came to Mary. He introduced that I'm Gabriel. I brought this message for you.
And poor Gabriel never ever seen naked person in Islamic paradise or in wherever man is created. Soon after she sees Khadija half naked, yeah. Freaks out and runs away. Sir, before you go, why don't you summarize the homeworks you've taken from him so that you will check it out for next week?
I'll summarize it in a second because I've got a Quran verse which justifies that Gabriel said that I am Gabriel.
Quranic verse justifies Gabriel said I am Gabriel to Muhammad.
Yes, that Gabriel is Gabriel. No, the Gabriel is the one that brought the Quran to Muhammad.
That's not what we are discussing.
No, I know that's not what we were discussing.
Just like bring up what we are discussing. Don't bring up the things we haven't discussed.
I will do my research on what we were discussing.
Yeah, so yes. Why are you bringing up like Gabriel brought the Quran?
Let me give you a simple logic here.
Yes.
Let me give you a simple logic.
Please do so. We are very much need of it.
Simple logic is this. If this message is from the true God, the true God can and has a power of making a literate person to read, to understand, and to recite. Yeah? True God can show the miracle. Can show the miracle. But since this message which Muhammad received is not from the true God, therefore, there was no miracle on Muhammad. That's why Muhammad, three times he said, Ma ana Bakari. He was unable to read.
I can't read.
So this proves that this message which Muhammad is receiving, not from true God. Because true God is telling the blind man to see, and his eyes open, and he started seeing each and everything.
No, that's the miracle, because when Muhammad can't read and cannot write, right? He can't read and he cannot write. That's just proof that he could have written the Quran himself. When some Christians claim that, you know, Muhammad wrote the Quran, right? It was man's word. You know, that's just
Quran is man's work, but Quran cannot be written by Muhammad because right. Muhammad
cannot read.
No.
Beside that, like Muhammad didn't even left the written Quran.
Yeah.
So, on the topic of the Quran, do you believe like there is only one Quran and never changed?
Let's not change the topic. Let me do this homework. Then I'll
You've been changing the topic. I asked you something very core, basic.
You're wearing it.
You haven't changing it.
Sir.
You haven't changing the
topic. I'm wearing it because what does that mean?
Exactly. How is it a narrative?
So, what does that mean? So you are Muslim. Tell me, what does that mean?
Right, so
how does this make you feel, so knowing your best scholars tells you there are holes in the narrative?
So you're saying that there are different Qurans. Okay. So you're saying that there are different Qurans.
I'm not saying that. Look who is saying that.
Yeah,
who is this guy?
Yes, sir.
So what did he say?
Apparently he said that there are holes in the
holes in the Quran. Yeah.
So
yeah.
What does it tell you about the different Qurans? And which Quran do you worship?
Right.
Do you follow?
97% of the world are Hafs Quran. Mm. Right?
So Hafs was the biggest liar, according to Islam.
And he was a stealer.
Stealer.
So That's not my question. So, do you acknowledge that there are different Arabic Qurans?
Until you bring me proof, no.
Oh, you want proof? You already give me the name of the Quran, but let's go to the basics. Hold this Quran number one. Hold this Quran number two. And then here's the example of 30 different Arabic Qurans. So let's do one basic to basic.
Wait, just give me one and then I'll research it.
No, I don't need to give you one. You already told you follow the Hafs Quran. Did Muhammad ever say, "Oh, Mr. Hafs, this is the Quran I want my community to follow"?
Did he say that?
No, because Muhammad never said Mr. Hafs Quran.
I want to see the difference between, let's say, Hafs and Warsh.
Okay, so you acknowledge that there are different Qurans?
Until you bring me proof.
Okay.
Yes. What's that? Wait, which type of Quran is this one?
How many types of the Quran are there?
You tell me. So
I'm asking you, how many types of the Quran are they?
The Qira'at.
What is that?
Qira'at are just like different ways that the Quran is pronounced. According to, like, for example, which country you are.
No, she's not talking about that.
Let's give him his young. Give me the evidence. So, no, so can you please explain it to me? What is Qira'at?
Qira'at.
Yeah, what is that?
So, what I know, right? So, Qira'at are like different ways of pronouncing the Quran, but it's the same meaning.
Okay. Are they written the same? Do they change the meaning?
Yeah.
No, the meaning are not changed. It's just the recitation.
No. Okay. Meaning has changed. Let me give you
just
example.
Just the pronunciation. You got examples.
And there is word us. What does es mean and what does os mean?
Give me two verses. There
is, I'm going to give you lots of verses, okay?
There is only a vowel difference.
I'm worried about
vowel
it.
Difference. Es and os. Do you know Arabic?
Algeria.
No.
Oh, you don't?
No.
I don't know pure Arabic.
Okay, can you come a little bit
closer? What does es mean and what does os mean?
So, let's do very basics, okay?
Yeah.
You don't know Arabic. Don't believe what I say, okay? But you already told me 97% of the world follows the Hafs Quran. That is the Hafs Quran.
And what Quran is that?
That's the Khalid Quran, okay? This Quran is different from Hafs Quran in 5,000 places. When you make a deep dive, okay? There are 5,000 textual variations between them. But you don't know Arabic, don't believe in me. Let's go to your Muslim missionaries. Your Muslim missionaries published a book, okay?
Give it to me.
That's very important, okay? Save that.
Yeah.
Save that, as there is no any other way. So this is by your Muslim scholar. Put together, he's talking about the 30 different Arabic Qurans, okay? Turn with me. I'm gonna just show you a couple of different differences, okay?
Give me one difference.
Is there a difference between I and you?
Yeah,
of course.
I and you.
What is the difference? He's not I.
Yes.
Agreed? Yeah? Okay.
Which kind of book is this?
That's Hadith? No. Wait. I'll talk to you. Wait just.
No. That's Quran. Yeah.
Are you here? Okay. So.
Yes.
Biricik's translation of the 10 Qira'at of the Noble Quran. Okay? The intention of this book is, author is showing you, because different Qurans, Arabic change the meaning, okay? Surah 37 verse 12. Rather, you were amazed as they ridicule. Okay? See, there is a footnote. D. You come to hear the footnote. Hamza, that's the name of the Quran. Al-Qisa, that's another name of the Quran. Kalaf, that's another name of the Quran. Three Quran names already here.
Yeah.
Read as Rada, I gravely noted as they ridicule. In here, it was you. In here, it became I. In here, one of them is Muhammad. In over there, one of them is Allah. Is that not a big difference? Is Allah is the amazed or is Muhammad the amazed?
Either they are same, either both are same, or if they are different, then Muhammad and Allah cannot be same.
They are united. They become one. And what happens according to Islam to shirk? Is there a difference? Do you believe there is a difference between Allah and Muhammad? Sorry?
Yeah, there is.
There is. What is the difference between Allah and Muhammad?
He's a God and the other one's a prophet.
One of them is God, one of them is prophet.
Yeah.
Can a prophet create everything?
No.
Allah does. Okay. While Muhammad is amazed over there in this book.
Is it okay if I can read it?
Of course you can read it. In this book it is Allah is amazed. I can show you the Arabic, but you don't know Arabic like 98% of the Muslim world. So this is when you do deep dive, what you see is there are holes in the narrative.
Yeah.
We should make a song about it. Are you focused, sir?
Yeah, I'm focused. That's why I'm reading.
Okay, so tell me, basic difference between Allah and Muhammad. That shouldn't be so difficult. Your Muslim scholars take the picture of the front page.
Yeah.
You can get the PDF. Right. Your Muslim scholars give you over 27,000 differences.
Yeah, okay, let me just take a picture of the book.
Right. So, it's not like right. Cool. Tell me. If this Muslim missionary is correct,
uh-huh,
and this Quran is correct, uh-huh, along top of that Quran, there are different Arabic Qurans. As you deep dive, you see there are holes in the narrative.
Yeah.
What are you gonna do about basics of your faith?
Right. Good question. Okay.
Not okay. Like, tell me if you find correct.
No. I'm not afraid. Wait.
It's not. I can see you're not afraid. If you are afraid, you wouldn't get speakers going.
No, I'm not afraid of saying that I can't answer a question.
Very basic question.
I'm not going to beat around the bush.
Have you not come across with Mr. Yasir Qadhi before? You came across Mr. Qadhi. It's been nearly a year.
Right.
And you haven't even bothered to check it out?
Right. No, because I was checking out something. I was checking about Christianity. That's what I was doing.
Don't you find it? I find it's very heartbreaking. Listen this. That's crushed off my heart. You bother to critic Islam, critic Christian faith, look into Christian faith, but you didn't even check your own faith with
the core of it. Yeah.
Quran, Muhammad, Allah.
You're doing the same
what
thing.
What I do?
You're being a hypocrite. I'll tell you why.
Oh.
Because you're saying if there's differences in the Quran,
yeah,
you're saying there's differences in the Quran,
yeah,
you're not aware of the differences in your own Bible.
I didn't say that. No. I never made a claim.
Yeah, I know.
Listen.
You're making a claim about me.
No.
I do not know about my Quran.
Whoa.
Yeah, you don't know. If you knew,
exactly,
you would tell me why I am holding two different Arabic Qurans.
You will bring the claim. Then we'll talk about that.
You will tell me why there are holes in the narrative. That's very simple. If you knew, very simple.
The passage you brought, I have explained you what this passage is talking about.
Right.
So you are teaching his religion.
Yeah.
While
I am teaching his religion as well as Bible.
While he's trying to find ways to critique your religion. Congratulations, brother.
Thank you.
Well done for teaching.
Thank you.
Well done for teaching Muslim about Islam so that he can critique your faith.
Yeah.
Because he's so busy to research the Bible.
That's hypocrisy. That's really hypocrisy.
No. It's not.
You can't say that the Quran this has differences and your Bible.
You was the one who brought the
brother.
Isn't it?
The claim you make is very different. The claim you are making is, do you believe there is only one Quran?
Yes.
So how can you still say yes while you just saw two different Arabic Qurans?
I'll research it.
So do your research.
Yeah.
Come to me about 30. It's not by the way, there are 37 different Arabic Qurans minimum.
Yeah, nice to know. All right.
Minimum. Yeah.
Minimum.
Yeah.
And in the time of Muhammad, in the time of Abu Bakr, in 900s, there were more Qurans.
Right.
And very soon, as the Saudi Arabia is getting rid of the Hadith, you will even get rid of the Hadith.
So since he's promising...
Brother, I just want to point out, another Muslim is taking my freedom of speech away by taking him away.
Yeah. I'll do my research on that.
So since...
next week, I promise. Yeah.
Since you are coming back, so why don't you find out... the Quran which is eaten by a goat as well. Find that Quran
and come with that Quran.
Come back, yeah.
Yeah. Come with that Quran also which is eaten by goat. Yeah? So please. Yeah. Eaten by goat. Eaten by goat.
That's it. What I'll tell you right now
Yeah.
is that even your own Bible.
Okay.
What is it?
You are not a Muslim. You are not a Muslim. Muhammad and Allah is full in love with Christian scripture. Have you noticed what happened? Yeah. The moment Quran is being on the question, what is the next thing happens? No defense of the Quran. Let me attack the Christian scripture.
With one sentence.
Doesn't work like that.
With your one sentence, you shot on the foot of Allah. Because Allah was the one who gave this Torah, Zabur and Injil.
Bang, bang, bang. Allah only
Allah was the one who gave this Torah, Zabur and Injil. If you are saying there is a difference in Torah, Zabur and Injil, then
Allah
you are shooting your Allah.
Bam, bam, bam.
Yeah.
Allah is a liar.
That's a lie. That's a clear cut lie. Yeah, that's a clear cut lie.
Come back next week.
The Quran says there is a guidance and there is a light in the Injil and in the Torah.
Does the Quran say Jesus is coming back?
Yes.
The Quran says Jesus is
coming back.
Does the
judge.
Bible say Jesus is coming
back? Oh, coming back.
Yes.
Brother, can you just tell my camera, summarize your conversation? Summarize what you were discussing with the gentleman.
Who is coming back?
Jesus. Yes, Jesus is coming back.
When Jesus comes back for the judgment, his judge, Christians are longing for Jesus' return. We are waiting. We are waiting for him with the songs and praises. Versus when I'll talk to you. Wait. Huh? Don't sleep too much, sir. You shouldn't be sleeping that much.
Yes, that. And the ants are eating Muhammad. Yeah, you saw.
No, he was being tortured by angel. Don't be that generous. He was being tortured by angel. Why don't you summarize your conversation to my camera person?
There are 25 prophets. All of them were.
So, how are you? A gentleman came to me and he asked a question that how can Abdullah be not a Muslim? Whereas I told him that Abdullah, because his name means the slave of Allah. So Abdullah was born in pagan family. He lived as a pagan. He worshipped pagan Allah. He died as a pagan. Therefore, which Allah servant he was? He was the servant of pagan Allah.
Pagan.
Yeah. So this was the conversation that Muslim boy brought to prove me that Abdullah was a Muslim.
I'm a new messenger.
Muslim.
I'm a new messenger. I saw Jesus in my
dreams. The clear cut evidence is seen here that Abdullah was pagan and Muhammad was the worshipper of pagan Allah, and Allah himself is a pagan god.
So, on the topic of the Muhammad comes from the lineage of Abraham, actually not true. Muslims are saying that, they are still saying that,
yeah.
Like a parrot. But when you break it down the genealogy, all you get is, actually, Muslims don't even know who comes before Adnan. That's all, it's crushed. Sad reality. Like a young sir, I told you to repent. If you wait a little bit, I will help you to repentance. Okay, hold on. So here's something very interesting. Young generation of Muslim mind spends all of their time to read the Christian scripture in the intention of attacking Christian scripture. That's all they do. He came to me early. Oh, he's looking at the Bible. He's questioning about Bible. Why are you Muslim? Because Islam is basic. Asking very basic question of lineage of Abraham. Asking very basic question. Sorry, lineage of Muhammad, asking very basic question on Quran, simply Muslim as, I don't know, I'll check it out. That's very core. Like, you've got two legs to walk on. You should know what your legs look like. You should know if you shave your shit or not. Those are very basic core. But because they spend their time to critique Christian faith, and Islam never been accountable, therefore all they do is run away.
Right.
I'll come back next week. But here's the bottom line.
What's the bottom line?
Yes, maybe approximately last year this time, Muslim missionaries expressed that there are holes in the narrative. Why? Because there are different Arabic Qurans. And Allah knows, nothing knows best why there are holes in the narrative. Only the correct Quran is going to intercede for Muslims, saying, oh, 97% of the Muslim world follows Hafs Quran, or saying, only 5% of Muslim world follows Wash Quran, doesn't help anything. Bottom line is, Muhammad never put his hand on the Hafs Quran and then said, this is the one, it's going to intercede for you. There are holes in the narrative today, with minimum of 37 different Arabic Qurans, but none of those Qurans are going to intercede for you on the Day of Judgment, Muslims. It is only Lord Jesus Christ. It is only Lord Jesus Christ who can intercede for us. And he is interceding for us. Why? Because he's got holes in his hand.
Amen.
He's got holes in his feet.
Amen.
My sin caused him to have holes in his hand.
Amen.
My sin caused him to have holes in his feet.
Amen.
And that truly God man is willing to intercede for us.
Yeah.
Muslims, give it up. Give that ideology with its holes in it up and turn to Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
There is no any other way. No any other way.
So now I am telling you, Allah speaks to me in my dreams and he told me, you are a messenger, you are Khalifa, you are Sultan. And I saw Muhammad in my dreams. Sorry?
Are you drunk?
I am not a drunk.
Okay.
Looks
I'm
like.
Not a drunk.
So let's keep this account up.
I am Muslim. I don't drink.
Huh?
You don't drink?
No.
I guess you are longing to have this wine of Riva in Islamic paradise. Make your point.
I saw Jesus in my dreams. He told me, I am coming back to the ear. I am coming to the ear. He said two times.
So Jesus is going to come. Jesus is going to
Listen.
Jesus is going to come. Jesus is going to come as a just judge.
Yes.
Are you ready for just judge?
Yes, I am a messenger.
That's not my question. Listen.
Syria.
Are you ready for the just judge, Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, to turn up today? Are you ready?
I am ready every time.
You are ready? How did you dealt with your sins?
Sorry?
How did you dealt with your sin?
Yes.
How did you dealt?
Because the God told me I love you and you are my messenger.
Okay. God told you he loves you and you are his messenger.
Yes.
So that wasn't my question.
Messenger.
That's not my question. My question is, how did you dealt with your sin?
Question.
You don't need to be Einstein for that. How did you dance with your question?
Can you change the question?
I can't change the question.
In a different way. Ask me in a different way.
Yes, I understand.
Are you sinner? Do you sin?
Sin.
Yeah. No.
Are you
sinner?
You don't sin?
No.
Man who says I have no sin already committed sin.
So you are not sinner.
You are not sinner.
Sin means crazy, right?
Huh?
Sin means crazy?
No, sin means when you
mistakes. Mistakes in your life. Mistakes in your life.
Not when you go against God.
Against God.
When
God
you reject God. Jesus
no,
as the Son of God.
I don't go against God.
You don't go against God. Mm. Do you believe Jesus is the Son of God?
No.
So you went against
God.
Repent.
No, I am not against the God. I put the cross for 2 hours. I saw a dream. Every day I dream. I saw a dream, my back cuts to 20 pieces. Just 2 hours on the Facebook.
That doesn't look like a dream, that looks like a nightmare.
No,
let me deal with something.
Every day I dream.
What's your name?
Huh? My name is Yasir Alamari.
Yasir, it seems that you are sleeping a lot, okay?
No.
I sleep approximately 5 hours per week and I think that is a lot. And I don't waste my time with the dreams.
Listen.
Since you sleep a lot and you have lots of dreams, okay, let's get to the chase. Can you tell me, God who spoke to you in your dream and identified you as a messenger, tell me about that God, what that God looks like. Because
he
I can check
like
out.
A man in the sky.
Oh, man in the sky.
Yes.
Allah.
He was Allah.
So you saw Allah? Man in the sky.
Does he have the two shins or one shin?
Two shins?
Yeah. Does he have two right hands?
I saw him.
Does he have two right hands?
Oh, you saw from his breast?
Yeah. He saw Allah from his chest.
Yeah, he saw Allah from the breast.
Does he have two right hands?
He had.
And no left hand?
He had two right hands.
Okay.
Two right hands.
Okay. So you saw Allah on the sky with two right hands from chest.
Chest up.
So did you see Allah was wearing clothes?
Yes.
What color?
White.
I thought that was green. Sir, don't sleep that much. Repent and turn to Lord Jesus Christ. He's the bottom line.
You are wrong then.
People have
been. I am not wrong.
Yeah, because Muslim, they don't believe white color. Yet they believe green color.
I've got the green. Okay, is this the one you saw in your dream?
This is not the truth.
You haven't read the Quran. You haven't read the Hadith. So you don't know. You don't know anything.
No. The one you saw in your dream was did he look like this? The one you saw in your dream, okay?
Yes.
The one you saw in your dream, did he look like this? Chest up? So you can see breast up, two right hands?
No.
No, he didn't look like this?
No.
Are you sure this is Allah?
He's a beautiful man.
Yeah, he's beautiful. He's on the sky. You can see two right hands. You can see him from the breast up. Yes. Okay?
Two right hands.
Yes.
Yeah, that looks like Allah to me.
This is not good.
Why?
This is not good.
Why?
That's the shin of Allah.
Who's this?
That's Allah.
This is Allah.
Yeah.
That's Allah.
No, this is
Allah.
This is not good.
Huh? Why?
No.
Why?
You didn't like him?
No.
This is the one who revealed himself with the two right hands from the sky.
I saw him in the sky, very beautiful man.
Yeah, he's very beautiful.
Very beautiful man.
Allah is very beautiful. Allah is very beautiful because Allah is a deceiver. He came to Muhammad in the shape of the man. Yeah, as a 13 years old man. Yeah, but let me state something. Allah is beautiful. Allah is so beautiful.
Yeah.
He is identified as a deceiver. Allah is so beautiful. He is identified as an abuser. Allah is so beautiful. Yeah. He is a liar. Allah is so beautiful,
he has
no judgment skills.
Yeah.
Judgment.
No judgment skills at
no
all.
No judgment skills at all. Allah is so beautiful, he doesn't know the basics.
Huh?
That's
listen
the Allah.
To me. Listen to me. What Allah told me in my dreams.
Huh?
He told me the Khilafah is
did
coming
Did Allah
soon.
Tell you to repent?
The Khilafah is coming soon.
Yeah. Where?
Yeah. If Allah where? Didn't tell
in
you to
Arabic
repent,
countries.
That's...
In Arabic countries?
If the one,
yes.
No.
Brother,
they will control the world.
Brother.
He
if,
told me they will control the world.
The guy on the sky, he sees in dream, identifies as Allah.
Allah.
And then didn't tell him to repent. I believe that was Allah. Because Allah doesn't even bother for your repentance.
Yeah.
Allah doesn't want your heart. Allah doesn't care for you. That must be Allah. Yep.
So I'm telling you the truth.
He is taking you in a hellfire.
He's
taking you in a hellfire.
My dreams come true. When I dream, my dreams come true. Millions of people will become Muslim.
There are
because of me.
There are many people.
People are becoming Muslim.
Like
millions
of people will become Muslim
give
because
me,
of me.
Give me
you
top five reasons.
I will check
Sir,
out for the prize.
I don't have TV. Give me top five reasons. I am Christian.
Yeah.
Why should I become a Muslim?
Yeah, that's
because
why?
I will make miracles.
Sorry? Huh? You make
I
miracles.
I will make miracles.
You make miracles.
Miracles?
Yes. I make miracles. Look, this is a miracle. Just a moment. This is a miracle. Bible tells us. Bible tells us. People will make miracles. But if they are introducing another God, Deuteronomy chapter 13,
there
don't believe
no
in them.
God.
So,
I believe in Muhammad because I saw him in my dreams. He was speaking to the God. I believe
Muhammad
in Jesus.
Muhammad was speaking to God?
Yes, in my
Which
dreams.
Which language?
In Arabic
fun.
Language.
Oh, Muhammad was speaking to Allah in Arabic.
Okay.
Did Allah tell Muhammad? Oh, Muhammad, tell me, how can I serve you today?
Did he say that? You know he didn't say that.
He told him, I want people to pray more. He told him in Arabic language, I want
people
the nation to pray more.
So,
but Muhammad told him,
yes,
no.
Yes, Yes, sir, gentlemen.
This is too much.
Oh, Muhammad said that's too much?
Yes.
Oh, did you hear that? Allah is telling Muhammad, I want people to pray. Muhammad says, no, that's too much.
That's too much.
Allah, let's make a bargain. Allah says, oh, Muhammad, let's make a bargain. I am here to serve you. Whatever you wish, it is my commandment. Is that
so
that?
How many times Allah, Muhammad bounced between Allah and people?
50, 45, 40, 35, 30.
I am not
yes,
an educated man.
You are not educated man.
You are not educated.
You are like Muhammad then.
I will be
you are like Muhammad.
You are not educated.
He is like Muhammad.
You are not educated. Not educated. Let me give you the bottom line.
He said, I am not educated.
Let me give you the bottom line. If you are not educated, you've got to repent. With the claims you are making so much right now, you are going against the goodness of God.
I think you're making fun of the system.
Who cares? He's making fun of him. He is not right with God.
So I like the dreams.
It's not. I can't. It's not my business. He's having bad dreams or not bad dreams. That's not my business. But here's the thing. Doesn't matter you are educated or you are not educated. Okay? You are a sinner. You've got something filthy in your heart. Yes. I've got something filthy in my heart. This brother has something filthy in his heart.
Yes.
And only way we can stand in the presence of God, only way we can have fellowship with God when our hearts, when our brains, when ourselves are being washed away. Yes. And that can only be done by the blood of the Lamb of God, Lord Jesus Christ. He washed my heart. He washed the heart of my brother.
Yes.
He washed the heart of those who turned to him in repentance. So sad that you have not turned to him. Your hearts are not being washed.
You have a chance.
Therefore, you are not declared righteous. Therefore, you cannot spend eternity in the dwelling place of God. All I can say to you, give up those false ideologies. Give up those false ideologies and turn to Lord Jesus Christ. Turn to the Lamb of God who takes your sins away.
Yeah.
Turn to the one who cleans your heart as well as he will clean your dreams.
That's right.
That you don't need to waste that much time, 10 hours a day for sleeping. Okay?
Yeah.
All you need is turn to Lord Jesus Christ, stand
this.
Under his grace.
What?
And be declared righteous.
So they give me injections every month. Uh-huh. They give me one injection.
Those injections are the causing you to have the dreams.
But the dreams didn't go. The dreams didn't
go. You've got to turn to Lord Jesus Christ. Who is my dream? You've got to turn to Lord Jesus Christ, who revealed himself to people in dreams.
Yes.
You've got to turn to Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
With his death and his resurrection, he declares you righteous. There is no any other way. There is no any other door. There is no any other gate. There is no any other one. It is only Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Allah, while you see him from the chest up, sitting on the throne with his two right hands, that's gonna not help you at all.
No,
repent, sir.
Not.